queens and kings throughout history have typically slept apart because of a tradition followed by the upper classes. As the queen does not have to compete with husband Prince Philip for space or quiet for a serene night's sleep, how much sleep does she actually get? Queen Elizabeth II has an important job with a busy schedule, which can typically make it difficult to sleep. According to a sleep survey, the average amount of sleep achieved worldwide by adults over the age of 25 is 6.9 hours. Express.co.uk speaks to a sleep expert about how much sleep the Queen should be getting to help her function as effectively as possible. The Queen and Prince Philip have been married for more than 70 years, and it appears that their trick to keeping their marriage happy is to sleep alone. Sleeping in separate bedrooms has traditionally been the norm for the upper classes, according to Her Majesty's cousin, Lady Pamela Hicks. She said, "In England, the upper class always have separate bedrooms. You don't want to be bothered with snoring or someone flinging a leg around. Then when you are feeling cozy, you share your room sometimes. It is lovely to be able to choose. But what impact does that have on their sleep?" Lifestyle and wellness expert at Nectar Sleep Erin Berman says that older people often use separate bedrooms. She said, "We couldn't possibly comment on where Her Royal Highness chooses to rest her head at night, however, we do know that older people tend to migrate to separate bedrooms. This is often due to the fact that as we age, insomnia becomes more common, less time is spent in deep restorative sleep, meaning waking up is more common, and our bladders are more active. Sleeping in separate rooms gives both parties the best possible shot at a good night's sleep, by not disturbing the other." The Queen, aged 93, has ruled the country for 67 years, requires more sleep than she would during her youth. Ms. Berman said, "As one gets older, quality sleep still remains crucial to promoting a healthy lifestyle. As such, the Queen should still be aiming for 7-9 hours of rest in order to avoid napping on the throne." She added, "Sleep is just one of the many areas which are affected as part of the aging process. One documented phenomenon is known as the advanced sleep phase syndrome, whereby older people tend to fall asleep earlier and wake up earlier. Also, the time taken to fall asleep tends to increase, sleep fragmentation is more common, and periods of quality deep and REM sleep are reduced." Although in recent years, the Queen has started to share some of her duties with her son, the heir apparent, Prince Charles, in a bid to teach him the ropes, her job is still very commanding. In fact, she only has 2 official days off per year, Christmas Day and Easter Sunday. Every other day of the year, she receives the red box, which contains policy papers, cabinet documents, telegrams and other important documents, all of which have to be read, and where necessary, approved and signed. Ms. Berman said, "Day-to-day pressures and stressors are well known to have an impact on sleep, with twilight worries of running a country certainly enough to keep one up at night." Having said that, managing a demanding job as well as getting a good night's sleep is possible, and it's all about striking a good work-life balance. Reportedly, the Queen heads to bed at midnight and wakes up at around 8:30 a.m. each morning, which fits with the suggested amounts of sleep for an average adult. Ms. Berman added, "On average, an adult should aim for 7 to 9 hours of quality sleep a night to maximize their day-to-day well-being. However, sleep isn't one size fits all, and there are many factors at play which can affect the length needed, including age, gender and lifestyle."